Welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will see how we can install our first C# console application on Visual Studio. For that, first install Visual Studio. We have mentioned a link in the description of the video to install Visual Studio. After installing, go to File, click New and click Project. Here different project templates will be visible. Here it is, we are creating a console app. So you can directly type console here so that you can get different projects related to console. Here it is. I'll go for the console app .NET framework. Select this and click Next. You can name the app. Let's say I'll name it Amit First Console Application. Below you can see the location of the project. Here is the complete path of the project and the .NET framework is 4.7.2. Click Create. Now our first project will get created. Here it is, our first program is visible. This is the Solution Explorer, that is the Project Explorer. And here is the default code. We will print something now. This is a sample C# console application. Here we have declared a namespace. A namespace can have multiple classes, so we have created class that is accessible only within the same assembly. The interim point is the main function, just like in Java. It can be called without creating an instance of the program class. Okay, now let us print something. To print, we will use console.writeLine. And here I'll mention my name. This will output a text Amit Diwan. Okay, so I have entered Amit Diwan, it will output the same. Add a semicolon and press enter. Type console.readKey. Now what is this? When you'll keep the mouse cursor, it will explain you that this will obtain the next character or function key pressed by the user. The pressed key is displayed in the console window. Go to File, click Save All. Go to Build and click Build Solution. Semicolon is missing. Okay, yeah, this is fine now. I'll click Rebuild. It is completed, successful. Now let us run it. Click the Start button. Now it will print Amit Diwan. It printed it, Amit Diwan. Since we have used console.readKey, when I'll press any key, it will close. For a free C# and Visual Studio tutorial, refer to the link in the description of the video.